I'm Professor R. V. R. Giddi from Computer Science and Engineering Department of WIT Solapur. Today, I'll be focusing on principal conjunctive neural form, the various problem statements that we're going to solve as a part two. You will be able to convert the given equation into principal conjunctive neural form. Today's example, obtain the product of sums, canonical forms of the given formula or the following formula. The formula is P and Q and R, okay, and the second term is negation P and R and Q, and the third term is negation P and negation Q and negation R. Okay. Now, product of sums canonical form is also nothing but a principal conjunctive normal form. Okay. Now, the given formula is given formula. Now, if you observe the given formula, okay, say the given formula is say equation, say name it as a S, okay, and assume that this is equation number 1. If we look at this particular formula, what we observe, it is a summation of three terms, okay. Inside the bracket, it is a product of variables with the negation. Okay, it means they are mean terms are there, and the mean terms are taken into summation. Means the given formula is in the form of PDNF. Now we have to obtain PCNF. Okay, means that what we have to do, let us suppose this is equal to S. Okay, so the given formula is in S is a given PDNF. Now to obtain PCNF, okay, what we do, we take negation S. Okay, that negation S is nothing but principal disjunctive normal form of the remaining mean terms. As we know that there are three mean terms, okay, for three variables there are 8 mean terms are there. Okay, so three are already utilized in the PDNF. So remaining 5 mean terms are there that we have to take in a summation, that will be called as a negation S. Now look at this, okay, the mean terms are indicated over here. 8 mean terms are there, M0 to M7, okay, out of that, I have mentioned in a red color that are used in a formula S, that is negation P and negation Q, that is the third term, negation P and Q and R, that is the second term, and the third term is P and Q and R, okay. So M0, M3 and M7 are used in a S, or they are in the form of PDNF, okay, they are in the form of PDNF. So it is a summation of what? M0, M3 and M7. Okay, so it is a principal disjunctive normal form of these particular three mean terms. Now negation S is equal to what? PDNF of remaining mean terms, means we have to take a summation of remaining mean terms are PM1, okay, M1, that is M2, M3 is already in S, so M4 will come, M5 will come and M6 will come. Okay, apart from this M0, M3, M7, okay, remaining mean terms M1, M2, M4, M5 and M6 will come in the summation of remaining mean terms, that is equal to say negation S. Let us write down this M1, M2, M4, M5 and M6 in a summation, okay, and that negation S, okay. So this is S is equal to negation S is equal to, it is already, so negation S is equal to, here the actually formulas or the actually max term, mean terms are written over here. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 mean terms are written in equation number 2. So this is called as a negation S. To obtain principal conjunctive normal form, okay, we have to take negation of negation S, okay. So that will give us, so the remaining mean terms are, this is M1, that is negation P and negation Q and R, it is written over here, or negation P and Q and negation R, that is M2 is there. Then the third term is M5, P and negation Q and R, and the fourth term is P and negation Q and R, and fifth term is P and Q and negation R. So these all will come in a PDNF, that is a negation S, that is a summation of remaining mean terms. Let us go to the next slide, okay, which will focus on. So negation S is just repeated those statements over here in this slide, and now find out negation of negation S. Find out negation of negation S. Now this is nothing but what we'll do. Negation of negation S is equal to, we'll take negation, then we'll write the first mean term, okay, that is negation P and negation Q and R, then R, then we'll write negation and this second mean term, okay, then R, third mean term with a negation, R, fourth mean term with a negation, and R, negation with fifth mean term. Say this is equation number 3. This is equation number 3. Now here we have to take this negation inside the bracket. Okay, now see what will happen. If I take this negation inside the bracket, this will be using, of course, De Morgan's law. So negation of negation will go off. So it will remain simply P. It will be P R. So this AND will change to R. Okay, and this negation will go off. This negation will go off. So it will remain as Q. And this will become negation R, okay, and this will be R will be changed to AND, so this negation will go inside the bracket, okay, this negation will go inside the bracket. So what will happen, this negation will be applied to this negation P, so that will become P, this R will change to AND, this negation Q will be converted into negation Q, and negation R will be converted to R. Then R will change to AND. So negation applied, this negation to this third term. So this will be negation P R Q, or this R will change, AND will change to R. Okay, this R will change to R. This negation will be, R will become simply R. And this R will become AND. And take this negation to the fifth mean term. So this will become negation P R Q, or negation R, or rather this is the fourth, and the fifth one is over here after converting this R to AND. Okay, this negation will go into the bracket, so this will become negation P or negation Q or negation R. So this is what equation number 3 will be changing to equation number 4 after applying negation to the brackets. Okay, so they are, as I have explained here, it is P or Q or negation R. This AND will change, OR will change to AND, then the inside the bracket AND will change to OR, so it will be P OR negation Q or R. So wherever negation is there, that negation will go off. If negation is not there, negation will be applicable to that particular variable. Okay. And the third term is this OR will change to AND. Okay, negation will be applied to P, then this AND will change to OR. Inside the bracket, then Q was with negation. Now when negation, again one more negation will come, it will become only Q, and this negation R will become simply R. And in the last mean term it is negation P or negation Q or R. This is equation number 4. Now think and write, okay, order the max terms for the equation number 4. Order the max terms for the equation number 4. Okay, that equation number 4 was given here. What are the orders of these max terms? Okay, take a pause over here and write down the order of these max terms on a piece of paper. So the answer for that is, it is P or Q or negation R, that is M1. Okay, then M2 will be there, then M4, M5 and M6. Okay. So it is a product of M1, M2, M4, and M5, and M6. This is a required PCNF. This is the required PCNF. Okay, so before that, or in the previous okay, so this equation number 4, so this equation number 4 is a PCNF, is a PCNF, okay, it is a principal conjunctive normal form. So let us go to the next slides. That already we have, you have given the answer for this. These are the references, and I hope you have understood how to convert the given any formula into a product of some canonical form or principal conjunctive normal form. Thank you very much.